ever thanked Mark Zuckerberg? I mean, I saw the hands, I saw your hands, you're all on Facebook. And I must say that I'm very happy that Mark Zuckerberg was the person to introduce Facebook.com, and we use it in our everyday life, but we forgot to thank the man. So I thought it would be a nice idea to see how we can help Mark Zuckerberg. What are his problems? What is he doing? And I was thinking, what did he change in my life? And I found this small book, this cool diary, and I was reading it, and all my former classmates wrote something inside the book, so I really knew who was connected to me during then. And while I have, I think, 1,700 Facebook friends right now, I only had 20 friends by then. I could count them, I knew them by their names, I knew the way they dressed, and it was a small world. And then we have to imagine that right now, we're living in 2012, the average Facebook user has got more than 250 friends. And we got all these friends thanks to Mark Zuckerberg. Mark has a small problem. Because his baby child, Facebook, went to stock, to the stock market, and something dramatically happened. So when Facebook first was on the stock market, you could buy Facebook stock for only $38. And now a few months later, there's nothing more than left as $26 per stock. And to be honest, there is something I have to admit, and that is that the real moment that the stock started dropping, Mark was having his marriage. So I'm not sure if he has bright memories about that day, and my idea for this TED Talk is to solve his problem. One of the problems Facebook is facing is that more and more people are using mobile devices to access Facebook while they do not send any advertisements to our screens. We're just having fun, liking each other's posts. We're quite happy to be connected to each other through Facebook, but Facebook isn't earning money when we use our mobile device. Other people say like, yeah, well, Facebook isn't ready to show advertisements on mobile screens. Well, I do not think that's the problem. I think that Facebook knows that mobile advertisements are only responsible for 20% of the income of a normal advertisement. So as soon as they started broadcasting these mobile advertisements to our screens without having a new revenue model, people will see that Facebook isn't that much worth. How are we going to solve this problem? Well, Facebook is currently selling sponsored stories. So in the past, you put a picture or something else on your Facebook and your friends, or when you're working for a company, the fans of the company page, or in this matter, the fans of Joshua Redden, one of my favorite artists, would receive the message and would be able to like it, to share it, to do a lot of things with it. But Mark needs money. And a way to do that is just using the old business model, asking money for sending the message into the network of Joshua Redden. Joshua was mad. He wrote that only 15% of his fans would be able to see his messages and pictures when he doesn't want to pay for it. Well, Facebook says, well, that's not true. We didn't change anything. You can just put your photos, whatever you want to share, your concert dates on your page. And just as before, everyone who is friends with you or a fan is able to receive that message. Well, that's not true. Because when you open Facebook, not only the right side of the page contains advertisements, even more and more posts that are being put in your timeline contain the word sponsored, which means it's not social, it's just commercial, and people are paying for broadcasting that message. To be honest, I do not think that more advertisements is the way we can save Mark. We have to ask Google, the advertisement specialist on the internet, if selling more advertisements is a good idea. To be honest, Google did something strange. They have a lot of money and they can do a lot of great things with it. But instead of innovating, Google lends you the money for 8.99% interest rate per year, and you're able to buy advertisements with that money. This is something very weird, because Google is the search engine company of the world, and they decided not spending the money on finding more ways to show us advertisements. They just don't know what to do with their money. So how can we help Mark? First of all, we need to know what Facebook knows about us. And of course, we share our hobbies. For instance, Tycho, one of my best friends, he's playing the violin. And the other picture shows one of my favorite dishes. It's just a regular sandwich with some cheese, and I tend to spread the word on Facebook that I'm creating another sandwich, so Facebook knows what we like to eat, where we would like to go to eat. Facebook also knows which books you're reading, what the content is of the books, but also which authors you like more and less. That's cool. But how can you use that earning more money? That's not the only thing. Facebook also knows which profiles you're visiting. Facebook also registers which links you click on. Not only the links that bring you to another Facebook page, also links that lead to external websites. And when you add a link to a message on Facebook, you will notice that they download some of the contents of the page you're linking to. You can see the title of the page and a small description. And this information is stored as well into the Facebook database. So they know which external websites you're visiting and which information these websites contain. There's another thing that they could do. It is possible to see how people move their mouse cursor. And when you try to get that into your database as well, by recording it, you might notice that some parts of the Facebook website are more popular than the others. At the top left, you can see the Facebook logo, and you can see that a lot of people are clicking over there. But in this matter, Facebook can also see how you move your mouse to which parts of the content they deliver to you, and there are lots of theories about what this means, about your interest, the things you're looking at, and the things you really, really like. And this might be interesting for Mark to know that he can use this to earn more money, but how? Another thing is that Facebook knows exactly when we log in, when we log out, at which times we tend to watch news websites. Also, we know these like buttons all over the internet. We do not exactly know what they do with the like buttons, but these buttons could be used as well to see how we behave on other parts of the internet. Another big thing that's going to happen is that Google is going to introduce the Google Glasses. And the Google Glasses contain a camera and a microphone. And it's possible to record literally everything in our lives, showing people where we are, and through the glass plate, it's quite small, the glasses can project text to your eye. And when I watch to someone, for instance, here in the hall, I could see the name and the function of this person, and what this person is doing as a living, which makes it more interesting for a speaker to tell some part of his knowledge, because he knows to who he's talking to. Facebook built a camera as well. Facebook deals. This camera you will find on more and more and more places. Well, not just places, places where you can spend money. Because when you enter, for instance, a restaurant with this camera, there will be made a picture of your face. Facebook will be able to recognize that you are entering the restaurant, and a few seconds later, it's possible to receive a custom-made deal to your mobile phone. This deal is, of course, something you really like, because Facebook knows what we like. And the funny thing is, when you're sitting in a bar and watching to some people, when you would use such type of a camera, the Google Glasses, for instance, well, if Mark was using it with his Facebook data, he would know who you are and what you're doing for a living, and if you're studying or not, and if you're studying, if you are attending colleges or not. He knows everything about us. And even if your face is not inside the Facebook database, there are lots and lots of techniques to analyze a face, to know if it's more likely that this face is from a female or a male person, if this person is smiling or not. There are lots of things that you could learn from watching a picture of someone. And Facebook is doing that as well. The next step is that also objects on our pictures can be recognized. There are software techniques available that are able to see if something is a car or a bicycle, and if it's a more expensive or a cheaper one. We are sharing lots and lots and lots of pictures on Facebook, and these pictures contain a lot more information about our lives than we might know ourselves. Another next thing that will happen is the Internet of Things, which means that most of the electronics we use in our lives will contain an internet connection. So when you're leaving the office, heading to your home, and in your agenda is stated that you're having a day tonight, so you want to cook something, then your oven knows already that it should enable itself automatically and head to some type of temperature, of course, what is suitable for the dish you're going to make. And of course, the social media like Facebook will connect to our electronics, and they will gather the information. And not just here and now, but everywhere we are going to, and even where we were in the past. Because when you're sending a picture to Facebook that is made in the past, you can tell Facebook that you didn't make it today, but 10 years ago. You can even describe from all of your friends how you did meet each other. And when we want to shop, we go to Facebook, because Facebook shows us immediately which sunglasses, for instance, are available and which of our friends bought it earlier and was satisfied or dissatisfied. And by this, Facebook is gathering more and more and more information about us and our lives. And they're using connections to, for instance, our email, which they used or they started to do a short period ago. And later on, I expect, as well, our text messages, email, phone calls, and all this information will be gathered into the Facebook database, and they will know who we are. I downloaded my Facebook details. You can download it. But just the information you shared with Facebook yourself. So I wanted to print it. The problem is that my printer can only print 1,000 A4 papers, and then I have to change the inkjet patterns. So it was not possible to do it, but my file exists of 1,200 A4 pages. And this is only the information I shared myself with Facebook. And we are living in this very, very, very complex world with more and more complex questions. And a complex question never leads to a simple answer. And this is why I think that Facebook should seek something to use all this information for that adds value to us and other people in the world, so we can make sure that Mark and his company will get a higher stock notice. But how to do that? So let's see what are the big world problems. One of the world problems is the climate crisis. Can Facebook solve that? Well, to be honest, 1.3% of all the energy in the world, electronic energy, is being spent to data centers where Facebook and other internet companies are storing their servers. So the more we Facebook, the less energy is left to do other things. So I'm not sure if Facebook can solve this problem. Can Facebook maybe solve the economic crisis? That would be great, right? Well, to be honest, if we just project their stock line, I think we know why Facebook can't solve the economic crisis. They're not able to do that because they're not able to solve their own economic crisis themselves. Well, what Facebook can do, and what they did, is making sure that there are more people an organ donor. They enabled the possibility to share with your friends whether you're an organ donor or not. And by enabling that, thousands and thousands and thousands of people around the world became organ donor. The only thing is that Facebook doesn't earn money with this. Can Facebook solve wars? Well, we saw in the Arab Spring that at least Facebook can be a platform to people that want to communicate freely with each other. But I'm not sure if Facebook itself can solve a war. Maybe Facebook should become our new world police, because they know everything about us, where we are, where we were, where we're heading. And this way, the world would become much more safer. But I'm not sure if we are still willing to share all this information if Facebook becomes a police agency. Another big problem is the heading, the upcoming labor and raw material shortage. Can Facebook solve that? Well, maybe, but not permanently. So I'm not sure if this would be or could be the new business model for Facebook. Can they protect our privacy? Well, maybe one day you can buy your privacy back from Facebook. That's possible. I'm not sure how much money you have to pay for it, but I'm not sure if all the privacy we will lose is the fault of Facebook. So I'm not sure if they can solve that problem themselves. No, I think Facebook is going to solve another problem. There are more singles in the world than ever before. We're living with more and more people in small countries, and we differ more and more from each other. And it's not only the small village you're living in where you can choose from if you're seeking for a new partner. No, the world is your village. And there are more and more singles, and singles are less happy than people in a relationship. So I think that Facebook should try to solve all our love problems. And this way they can connect people to each other literally from all over the world. And no, I'm not suggesting that Facebook should become a dating site. I think Facebook knows that much about us that they can tell us who our ideal partner would be. Yeah, they can. And if they connect two people to each other, and when these two people fall in love and get married, I see a new business model. Because when you're happy together and after your first dates, you want to go to a cool place to have dinner, but you do not know where to go. Facebook can tell you where your partner wants to go. And another thing is that you can just, these advertisements, there are no advertisements anymore. We want to know where to go. Please, Facebook, tell us which company is willing to pay that much money to you that you can suggest us a date or a holiday place to go. You can earn money with everything, directing these people's lives in the right direction, helping them grow. And if you've got relationship problems, don't call a mediator. Go to Facebook. Because Facebook could use the latest insights on relationship conflicts and problems and give you advice how to solve it. No, I do not want this to happen. But I'm afraid that I nor you can stop this. There always will be people that are looking for a simplified world. Well, at least if Facebook starts doing this, there will be much and much more love. Thank you.